Welcome back to the channel. In today's video, I have a particular challenge with my form. Now, this form is for a safari company that is getting information from its clients about their inquiries. Now, in this section, they would like to have all the different safaris listed like a drop-down so that someone can be able to just choose one and then add them to this particular section. Thank you so much for the recommendation for those who responded to my post about the different forms. I really appreciate that, and I'll be looking at the different other forms that other people have recommended. Currently, I've been using Contact Form 7 and I've reached the limit. There is no way I'm able to do that unless I make a query and then I use JavaScript and then target this particular file, and then I'll be able to list those particular items in the dropdown. Now, if someone turns off JavaScript on their site, it might be a little bit hard for me to get that information in here. So what I'm going to do is I've found another plugin that's going to help me to do that, and that plugin is WP Forms. So I've installed WP Forms here. I'm going to activate it, and after installing it, I'm going to go to the settings section. I'll add my key and verify this so that I'm able to use WP Forms in its full performance. Now, of course, there is a price tag to the particular plugin that I'm going to use here, but it's going to allow me to do so much work in so little time. So you can go and make your purchase on wpforms.com/pricing. Inside my form, I'm just going to create a new form, and I get this new interface showing up for the forms. I'm going to say this is my booking form, and then I'm just going to choose a blank form. This will give me a whole setup of what I can use this with. So you'll see there are standard fields, there are fancy fields that you can have in here. You can also have something like the payment fields in the event that you want to do something to do with payments. But I am going to choose a very simple drop down. I'll drag and drop it here. And now that we have this drop down, it should be able to give us a couple of options. So I'll go to the field options here, and you're going to see that I am able to enter either different things. Like I can say this is going to be shoe, this will be t-shirt, this can be vests, for example. So that will allow us to have the different drop items. But this is not what I'm interested in, so I'm going to go for the advanced options. And in here, add dynamic choices. So I'm going to choose a post type, and you'll see that this automatically generates for me all the different post types that I do have. So in here, you'll see we have posts, we have pages, we have projects, we have testimonials, we have airlines, we also have safaris. So I'm going to choose safaris as my dynamic post type source, and that is going to allow me to add new safaris every other time that will automatically be added to my form. I do not always need to add those statically in here by having different options. So this is one of the powerful tools that I've actually seen with WP Forms. So you can now see that I have all different items listed in here. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to save this for now, and I'll click embed, and I'm going to add it to a new page so that I can try to view it. So I'm going to say view booking, and I'm going to hit let's go. Of course, it automatically opens up in here. I'm going to publish this for now, and then I'm going to view the page. So in this view booking page, you're going to see that when I click the drop down, I have all my different items actually showing up in here. So this is one powerful thing that I've seen. So what I'm going to do is let me add another safari to my page. So I'm going to go back here in the admin area, and then I'll go to safaris in here, I'll click add new. And now I'm going to add a new dummy safari, which I'll call ZZZZ Safari. And what I'm going to do is just publish that for now. We just need to make sure that it's actually showing up on the front end. So I'm going to reload this right here. And if I go to this drop down and scroll down, you'll see that we have our ZZ Safari showing in here. So I can actually add all these other fields that are pending right here, and then I'll be able to have a neat and nice form for me that will be submittable. So for me, this was a big plus. It was a big win. I'm going to be testing out WP forms a little more so that I can be able to see what happens in the backend. But right now, I'm impressed. If you found this helpful, if you think that you'll be able to use this in your project, let me know in the comments below how you are using WP Forms. Otherwise, if you found value in this video, give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to share it and also to subscribe to the channel if you think there is always value for you. Otherwise, enjoy whatever you're developing.